Have you ever wanted to create a 3D object like this with lettering on the iPad Pro? Well, today I'm going to show you how to create this insane 3D scene very easily and in no time at all. First thing you need to do is go to the sponsor of this video's website, Vectary.com. Vectary is a web app that allows you to create and share 3D design content for the web. And they've just released a new update. So I had this idea where I wanted to letter on top of 3D shapes, but I didn't know what to do. So I came up with this idea of maybe having like these dice that I can roll, and I want them to look like they're rolling and there's letters on top, and I can do some hand lettering on those dice. It would look really cool in a portfolio. So what I did was I went into Vectary and I brought out a simple square, a cube. I sort of messed around with the cube and then I duplicated it by pressing Alt and just dragging it on one of the axes. Messed around with that, made sure that they were sort of looked random enough, like there's movement within there. And I did that 6 times to spell the word create. I needed to change the textures of each of these. I wanted them to be plastic, but you can change the colors and everything else if you want to. If not, you can actually do that inside of Procreate as well. So go ahead, make sure that all my cubes are right, and I changed the texture to this plastic one. It had like this nice rough surface on it that I liked. I didn't want to change the background or do anything too crazy because I liked the neat minimal feel that these had. For more complex geometric shapes, I would recommend using the unwrap function. And there's a little bit of flare, go ahead and enable the ground plane, add the effect soft shadows. It just softens everything up and makes it look really nice. We're not going to change anything about the lighting. There's no point right now, because what we're going to do is we're going to export this. Go to the top left and go to export and make sure you change the file format to USDZ and press download. When you download it, you can then right click, and if you have a Mac, airdrop it to your iPad. When you do airdrop it, you'll be notified because it'll say, do you want to open this up in Procreate? And you got to hit that, open Procreate. Now 3D in Procreate is in its early form, so it can be a bit confusing if you're coming from 2D, but like me, I'm a 2D artist. I don't do 3D very often. It's pretty intuitive, like Vectary. Did I mention Vectary is completely free to use as well? It's pretty insane that you can actually do this. Technology is crazy. You can use one finger in Procreate to sort of orbit around and two fingers to sort of pan around and zoom in and zoom out. It's pretty easy, self-explanatory after 2 seconds of use. You'll notice when you tap on a square or an object, it will flash blue. That means that you've selected that. Now within the layer panel, what we need to do is add another layer from the background layer. This just ensures that we can add more elements later if we want to. I'm going to spell the word create, but each letter is going to be slightly different. I do this quite a lot on my Instagram, or I used to do this quite a lot, where I would change the letter form and the type style of it. It gives a cool effect. You'll notice where I'm drawing on there that every side is got the same letter form. It sort of mirrors it to each side of the die. So for the C, I go for a simple sans serif. It's simple as it gets. For the R, I go for a gothic one with a brush that I use a lot of the time. The E, I went for a script, just a simple Spencerian E. For the A, I used a pencil, just simply wanting to create this groovy A. And then I gave it some shadows in the outline. The T, I go back to gothic or black letter. And then the E, I just go for a standard semi-serif E, capital. Now inside of Procreate, you can go to the settings up at the top, go to 3D and change the lights and environments to your heart's content. And there you have an amazing 3D scene with your hand lettering on it that you've made yourself. You didn't have to download anyone else's work to do this or any mockups. It's right there. Once you're done designing in Procreate, you can go ahead and share it and share the texture as a PNG and bring it back to your computer. From your computer, you can go back inside of Vectary, click on the shape, and you can actually upload that texture straight back in to Vectary. We go ahead and change the color down here. We add the texture and we'll upload the color back again. I'm going to choose the plastic texture color here, and you'll see it will upload it straight back into Vectary, keeping the textures exactly what they were inside of Procreate. And once you've brought everything back into Vectary, what you can do is you can actually share it. And there's a few things you can do. You can share it to the web so anyone can have a link, and you can also bring it into augmented reality. To bring augmented reality in, all you need to do is go to the advanced tab and add augmented reality, and it will pop up for you. When we press share, we can go ahead and synchronize changes, we can copy the link. And this allows us to share it with anyone and to actually embed it on our website as well, which you can also do by copying the embed code. We can also go into augmented reality by pressing that banner and getting your camera on your phone, and you can take a QR code scan of this and it will show the augmented reality on your phone. Now, Vectary is amazing for this, not only because it's made essentially for 2D artists to learn 3D, but there's not really much of a learning curve. You can just get straight into it and it's free to use. So I'll be really excited to see what you guys create with this. Thank you again, Vectary, for sponsoring this video and letting everyone know about this update. If you did enjoy this video and you want to see more content, press that red subscribe button and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.